Hello everyone, welcome back to this series called Finance Current Affairs, where we pick up some important financial topics and we try and discuss them with the help of different questions. So before moving on to the first question, if you haven't subscribed to our channel, please do subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you can be notified about all our upcoming videos. You can also join our Telegram group, the link is in the description below. Free PDFs of these sessions will be available on that very group only. Moving on to the first question then, which says, RBI has put in place some trigger points to assess, monitor, control and take corrective action on banks that are weak and troubled. It is done to make sure that the banks don't go bust. The process or the mechanism under which these actions are taken is known as the PCA framework. What is the full form of PCA? So, you would have heard about the PCA framework, which is applicable on banks, where RBI takes up different actions in the bank in order to assess their performance, monitor it, control it, to make sure that the banks don't go bust. So what's the full form of that PCA framework? PCA stands for the Prompt Corrective Action Framework. So answer is option D. Let us discuss a bit about this framework and why I'm discussing it. That's because RBI has recently released a revised PCA framework. थोड़े दिन पहले ही आरबीआई की वेबसाइट पे रिवाइज्ड पीसीए फ्रेमवर्क आया है एंड दिस फ्रेमवर्क इज एप्लीकेबल ऑन बैंक्स फ्रॉम द नेक्स्ट ईयर ऑनवर्ड्स दैट इज फ्रॉम 1st of Jan 2022. सो लेट्स फर्स्ट ट्राई एंड अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज दिस पीसीए फ्रेमवर्क, देन वी विल कम टू व्हाट्स द लेटेस्ट रिवाइज्ड पीसीए फ्रेमवर्क ऑल अबाउट. सो द प्रॉम्प्ट करेक्टिव एक्शन फ्रेमवर्क इज देयर टू मेक श्योर दैट द बैंक्स डोंट गो बस्ट. Banks play a really very important role in our financial system. Okay, so it's very important to monitor the performance of banks, to keep a check on it, to control their performance. If these banks are heading towards any kind of a problematic situation, they are not maintaining enough capital, their loans are, their more and more assets are becoming NPAs, then there is a need for RBI to intervene and take certain measures in order to control the performance of these banks. Okay, it's very important to make sure that timely measures are taken so that banks don't land up in a problematic situation. That is ensured through this PCA framework. So this framework prescribes certain parameters based on which the performance of banks are assessed. Now, if the banks breaches those threshold which RBI has specified, then those banks will come under the PCA framework and RBI will impose a lot of restrictions on these banks to bring their performance back on track. Okay, so it's a framework under which banks which are having weak financial metrics are put under watch by RBI to assess, monitor and control the banks. So RBI ne alag alag parameters decide kiye hue hain jisse ki jin basis pe wo banks ki performance assess karte hain. कुछ रिस्क थ्रेशोल्ड्स है, अगर आप उन्हें ब्रीच करोगे तो आरबीआई आपके अगेंस्ट एक्शंस लेगा. वो थ्रेशोल्ड्स ब्रीच करने का मतलब ये है कि बैंक्स की परफॉर्मेंस सही नहीं जा रही, वो कहीं ना कहीं वीक है, कहीं प्रॉब्लमैटिक सिचुएशन में वो है, और इससे पहले कि वो और बड़ी क्राइसिस में फंस जाए उससे पहले ही आरबीआई कुछ एक्शंस ले लेता है. सो दिस इज व्हाट पीसीए फ्रेमवर्क इज ऑल अबाउट. इट्स बेसिकली एन अर्ली इंटरवेंशन पैकेज बाय आरबीआई वेयर द बैंक्स दैट when a bank turns weak in terms of certain identified indicators. So if the banks are not performing well, that is going to be assessed through these parameters specified under the PCA framework. And in case the situation of banks become weak, then the RBI will intervene. And as far as the early intervention package is concerned, they will impose certain restrictions on the banks. It will take certain actions so that the bank's performance will soon come back on track and they will not land into any kind of a crisis or any kind of a problematic situation. So it enables the supervisory intervention of RBI over banks at appropriate time. Overall, this thing is going to ensure the market discipline. Agar banks ki performance sahi rahegi, to overall hamara system ki stability bhi maintained rahegi. So this is the PCA framework. Now let's come to the revised framework. So this revised framework is applicable to all banks that operate in India. It will include your Indian banks operating in India or foreign banks which are operating in India through branches or subsidiaries. Payment banks and small finance banks have been removed from the list of lenders on whom PCA can be initiated. Alright. Now talking about the monitored areas, PCA framework ke andar k किन एरियाज की मॉनिटरिंग की जाती है जिसके बेसिस पे ये डिसाइड किया जाता है कि बैंक की परफॉर्मेंस अच्छी है कि वीक है. सो द पैरामीटर्स बेस्ड ऑन विच इट्स डिसाइडेड वेदर द परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ बैंक इज गुड इनफ और इट इज वीक आर द कैपिटल असेट क्वालिटी एंड लीवरेज पैरामीटर्स. सो इनफ कैपिटल बैंक्स मेंटेन कर रहे हैं कि नहीं, आर द बैंक्स मेंटेनिंग इनफ कैपिटल, इज द असेट क्वालिटी गुड और मोर एंड मोर लोन्स आर टर्निंग इनटू एनपीए, what is the extent of leverage taken by banks, all these things are assessed using four different ratios. So these things can be tracked using the following indicators. Capital can be assessed through the CRAR or the common equity tier 1 ratio, that is the set 1 ratio. Okay, these are the capital adequacy requirements prescribed by Basel, adopted by India. Then we have the net NPA ratio. So CRAR है कि आप कितना capital maintain कर रहे हो, are you maintaining enough capital against your risk weighted assets or not. Net NPA ratio shows what is your the extent of NPAs as far as your overall advances are concerned. आपने जितने भी loans लिए हैं उसमें से कितने आपके NPAs हैं. And then we have the tier 1 leverage ratio. Tier 1 capital we all have discussed various times is the core capital of banks. Okay, then we also have tier 2 capital, which is the supplementary capital. So what, how much is the tier 1 capital maintained vis-a-vis overall total consolidated assets of the banks is determined using the leverage ratio. So all these indicators are used to assess the capital asset quality and leverage of the banks. Earlier we had one more parameter on the basis of which the profitability was assessed. That was the return on assets. Now in this revised framework, it has been removed. Ab sirf profit, ab profitability hum nahi assess karenge, ab capital, asset quality aur leverage hi assess karenge in char ratios ke basis pe. So let's see what are the risk thresholds which if breached, then RBI will intervene and take supervisory actions on these banks. So RBI ne kuch risk thresholds batai hai ki agar isse kam aapka capital adequacy ratio गया, इससे ज़्यादा आपके NPAs हुए या इससे ज़्यादा कम आपका leverage ratio हुआ, तो क्या RBI करेगा? Okay, तो risk thresholds हैं कि अगर आप इन risk thresholds को breach करोगे, तो RBI आपके against action लेगा. Let's see what are these risk thresholds which if breached, then RBI will intervene and take actions against you as a bank. So first is the breach of the capital parameter, that is breaching the CRAR and the set 1 requirements. CRAR plus capital conservation buffer, both of these are requirements specified under the Basel and adopted by India. Suppose we say that the CRAR is to be maintained at 9% and we say that capital conservation buffer is to be maintained at 2.5%. So 9 plus 2.5 11.5 is say the regulatory requirement. अगर हम कहें कि 11.5 आपको CRAR और कैपिटल कंजर्वेशन बफर मेंटेन करना है, तो रिस्क थ्रेशोल्ड किस की इन इस केस में क्या है, व्हाट्स द रिस्क थ्रेशोल्ड इन दिस केस. सी ड्यूरिंग कोविड दिस कैपिटल कंजर्वेशन बफर रिक्वायरमेंट वाज रिड्यूस्ड. ओके, इट वाज अलाउड टू हैव अ लेसर रिक्वायरमेंट, सो एट दैट टाइम द रिस्क थ्रेशोल्ड्स वर डिफरेंट, नाउ दे आर डिफरेंट. सो व्हाटएवर इज द रेगुलेटरी रिक्वायरमेंट, लाइक इन दिस केस इट्स 11.5%. So when will there be a breach? It will be when up to 250 basis points below the indicator prescribed in column 2. So 250 basis points means around 2.5%. If you see 1 basis point, it is around 1 by 100%. Okay, so if it is that you are breaching it by 100 basis points, so 100 basis points means 100 into 1 by 100, that is 1%. Right, here we have 250 basis points. So 250 by 100 is equal to 2.5%. So up to 2.5% below the indicator prescribed is the risk threshold 1. That means 11.5 minus 2.5, that is 9%. So if your CRAR plus capital conservation buffer is between 9 to 11.5%, then in that case you are breaching risk threshold 1. Secondly, more than 250 basis points but not exceeding 400 basis points. So 11.5 minus 4, 7.5. 2.9%. So if you are maintaining CRAR plus capital conservation buffer between 7.5 to 9%, that means you are breaching the risk threshold 2. Thirdly, in excess of 400 basis points. That means if you are maintaining CRAR plus capital conservation buffer less than 7.5%, then you are under the risk threshold 3. So in each of these thresholds, different actions are taken by RBI. 250 basis points ka matlab hai 2.5%. Okay, 1 basis point 1 by 100% ke barabar hota hai. 400 basis point ho gaya 4%. तो अब इसमें क्या है, जो भी आपकी रेगुलेटरी रिक्वायरमेंट है, जैसे कि अगर 11.5 रेगुलेटरी रिक्वायरमेंट है तो आप 250 बेसिस पॉइंट्स तक, अप टू 250 बेसिस पॉइंट्स बिलो दिस आप रिस्क थ्रेशोल्ड 1 में होते हो, और उससे ज़्यादा अगर आप बेसिकली जो भी लिमिट्स है उसको सरपास कर रहे हो, यानी कि जितना मेंटेन करना है उससे भी ज़्यादा कम कर रहे हो, जितना कम करते जाओगे आप ज़्यादा रिस्की थ्रेशोल्ड में आ जाओगे और आपके अगेंस्ट और ज्यादा स्ट्रिक्ट एक्शंस लिए जाएंगे. ओके, सो टू अंडर द फर्स्ट रिस्क थ्रेशोल्ड अप टू 250 बेसिस पॉइंट्स बिलो द इंडिकेटर इज द लिमिट. अंडर रिस्क थ्रेशोल्ड 2 मोर देन 250 बेसिस पॉइंट्स बट नॉट एक्सीडिंग 400 इज द लिमिट. एंड अंडर रिस्क थ्रेशोल्ड 3 इन एक्सेस ऑफ 400 बेसिस पॉइंट्स बिलो द इंडिकेटर इज द लिमिट. Similarly, if you are not breaching the CRAR plus CCB, but you are breaching the SET requirements, that is the Common Equity Tier 1 capital requirement, then also RBI can take actions against you. So what are the risk thresholds under this very case? The risk thresholds is up to 162.50 basis points below the indicator. So whatever is the limit prescribed for India, okay, whatever is the SET ratio plus CCB applicable to India, 162.50% basis point below that is a risk threshold 1. More than 162.50 but not more than 312.50 is the risk threshold 2, and in excess of that is the risk threshold 3. तो जैसे हमने first case में निकाला, ऐसे ही set ratio की जो भी set और CCB की जो भी requirement है उससे आप इतना basis point को percentage में convert करके जब कम करोगे, accordingly आप risk thresholds निकाल सकते हो. RBI has specified the risk threshold in terms of basis points right now. Moving ahead to the second indicator now, which is the asset quality. For asset quality, which indicator is used? Net non-performing advances ratio. So, jitne zyada aapke NPAs badhte jayenge, utne zyada matlab aapki performance deteriorate ho rahi hai. To utna zyada aapke against strict action liya jayega. The more the NPAs you have, the more strict actions will be taken against you because it denotes more deteriorating situation for the banks. So, the risk threshold one is more than 6 but less than 9%. For risk threshold 2, it's 9 to 12. And for risk threshold 3, it is more than or equal to 12%. So you see, the more this ratio, that means the more NPAs you are having and more stricter actions will be taken against you. The last parameter is leverage, for which we use the regulatory minimum tier 1 leverage ratio. So whatever is the regulatory requirements, up to 50 basis points below that, that means 0.5% below that is the risk threshold RAG 1. More than 50 basis points but not exceeding 100%. Yani ki jo bhi limit hai, usse 5 to 1% ki range jo hai kam, wo risk threshold 2 hai. And more than 100 basis points means more than 1% below that regulatory requirement, you will be under breaching the risk threshold 3. So jo bhi ratio hoga, uske according aap basis points ke basis pe निकाल सकते हो कि आप किस केस में रिस्क थ्रेशोल्ड्स को ब्रीच कर रहे हो. सो व्हाट एक्शंस विल आरबीआई टेक बिफोर डिस्कसिंग दैट, आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू दैट हाउ द पीसीए रिस्ट्रिक्शंस विल बी विदड्रॉन. आरबीआई हैज द पावर टू इम्पोज दिस पीसीए फ्रेमवर्क ऑन बैंक्स एंड विदड्रॉ इट. सो इफ ऑल दीज इंडिकेटर्स विच वी हैव सीन, इफ दे आर नॉट ब्रीच्ड फॉर 4 कंटिन्यूअस क्वार्टर, then for four after assessing the 4 continuous quarterly financial statements, is if RBI finds that they are not, these banks are not breaching the risk thresholds, then the PCA framework will be taken away from that bank. Or if RBI believes that the profitability of bank is sustainable, its position is good, then also RBI can withdraw a bank from this framework. So 4 continuous quarterly financial statement agar ye dikhati hai ki wo bank RBI ki risk thresholds ko breach nahi kar raha ya uski jo profitability hai wo achhi khasi hai, sustainable hai, to us case mein kisi bhi bank jis pe PCA framework applicable tha, RBI us framework se us bank ko bahar nikal sakta hai. So jo bhi restrictions imposed ki jati hai wo phir nahi ki jayengi. So what are the restrictions imposed? When a bank comes under the PCA framework, what actions are taken against the bank? See, 2 types of actions can be taken. One is some set of mandatory actions, jo to liye hi liye jayenge, and some are the discretionary actions which might or might not be taken by RBI. So if you breach the risk threshold one, then RBI will put a restriction on your dividend distribution or on remittance of your profits. And it will also impose restriction where the promoters, owners or parent company bring in the capital. So, aapke dividend distribution pe restriction lag jayega aur promoter ya owner ke aur capital lane pe bhi restriction lag jayega. Ye mandatory action hai. Under risk threshold 2, both of these mandatory actions are there. In addition to that, there will also be a restriction on expanding your branches. Aap apni branches domestically ya overseas expand nahi kar paoge, RBI aap pe restriction laga dega. And in case of risk threshold 3, all these actions which we have discussed under risk threshold 1 and 2 are applicable. And in addition to that, RBI will also impose certain restrictions on your capital expenditure. So, these are mandatory actions which will be taken if you breach in risk thresholds. There are some discretionary actions also which might be taken in case of breach of any of these three risk thresholds. So they are your supervisory actions, strategy related actions, governance related actions, capital related, credit risk related, market related, HR related and many such actions. So inke under kya kya actions liye jaate hain, ek bar hum inhe briefly dekh lete hain. What actions are taken under this? Let's discuss them briefly. These are some of the discretionary actions taken. So as far as the supervisory actions are concerned, some special supervisory monitoring meetings will be held timely. Special inspection, special audit will be done for those banks. Resolution will be done for those banks using an amalgamation or a reconstruction process. So, ye kuch supervisory actions diye ja sakte hain jab banks jo hai wo risk thresholds ko breach karte hain. Iske alawa kuch strategy related actions bhi diye ja sakte hain. Some strategy related actions can also be taken against the banks. Like RBI can advise the banks to activate a recovery plan, to come up with a detailed review of their business model, review their short term, long term, medium term plans. Then RBI can advise the bank's board to undertake the business process re-engineering to restructure their operations. So strategy related ye kuch actions hai, ye kuch advice hai jo RBI board ko dega aur unhe implement karne padenge. Governance related actions can also be taken, that like RBI can take over or supersede the board of that bank. It can engage with the boards of the bank on various aspects. It can remove the managerial person, impose restrictions on their compensation. So governance improve karne ke liye RBI ye sare decisions le sakta hai. And talking about the capital related actions, so various restrictions can be imposed that the banks can't use their capital to invest in high risk sectors and in the high risk weighted projects and high risk weighted assets. The RBI can impose restrictions on investing in the subsidiaries. So these sare capital related actions hain jo RBI aapke against le sakta hai jab aap PCA framework ke under aaoge. Iske alawa kuch credit risk related actions bhi le sakta hai RBI. RBI can take certain actions to make sure that your credit risks are minimized. Okay, it can prepare a time bound plan for you in order to reduce the NPAs. It will mandate you to have more provisions for NPAs, reduce your loan concentrations in certain sectors. So aapko kahan loan dena hai, NPA ke liye kitna provision create karna hai, un sab cheezon se related restrictions RBI aap pe impose kar sakta hai. या कुछ rules regulations के साथ आ सकता है. Talking about market related actions, so RBI can impose restrictions on your borrowings, on your using different derivative instruments or other instruments, okay, in order to reduce the overall exposure to the market risk. Then talking about the HR related actions, RBI can restrict expansion of your staff. It can review the training of your staff. Aise kuch actions liye ja sakte hain HR related jab banks ki performance achhi nahi hai. Talking about profitability related actions, so RBI can impose restrictions on your capital expenditures, on your costs which you are incurring. And then talking about operation related, aap jo bhi operations karte ho us pe RBI restrictions laga dega. RBI can restrict your operations, like it can restrict your branch expansion, your plan of entering into new business lines, your plan to invest in various assets, to outsource various activities. These are all types of restrictions RBI can put. Besides, actions appropriate lagte hain, wo actions RBI le sakta hai. Other than these, also RBI can take the needed actions. So this is all about the revised PCA framework. I hope it is clear now. Coming to the next question, but before that, let me tell you the current status of PCA. सो अभी कौन सा बैंक पीसीए फ्रेमवर्क के अंडर है? ओनली सेंट्रल बैंक ऑफ इंडिया. वी हैड टू मोर बैंक्स अंडर दिस फ्रेमवर्क which were the UCO Bank and the Indian Overseas Bank, which have been taken out of this framework recently in September. इससे पहले UCO Bank और Indian Overseas Bank भी इस framework के अंदर थे, लेकिन September में ही इन दोनों banks को PCA framework से बाहर निकाल दिया गया क्योंकि इनकी performance improve हो गई थी. And as far as the current status is concerned, the Central Bank of India is under this framework and RBI is imposing the restrictions on it. Coming to the second question related to this, which says, which of the following are the key parameters that will be used to track capital, asset quality, leverage associated with revised PCA framework? So, अभी हमने देखा इन तीन parameters के लिए चार indicators हैं, CRAR, SET, NNPA and regulatory minimum tier 1 ratio, leverage ratio. So, all these three are the parameters. Return on assets was there earlier but now it has been removed. So, answer is option B. Coming to the third question. Which of the following action is a mandatory action? Which of the following is a mandatory action taken when a bank breaches risk 2 threshold and is placed under PCA? So risk 1 threshold wale jo restriction hai, wo bhi implement hogi aur uske alawa branch expansion wali restriction bhi lagegi. So restriction is there, branch expansion is there and restriction on capital expenditure. This is a mandatory action if you breach 3rd risk threshold. Okay, so only first two. Answer is option B. These were all the questions related to PCA framework. Let's come to the last question and next topic of the day, which says, identify the specialized financial institutions that buys the NPAs from banks and financial institutions so that they can clean up their balance sheet. These institutions, okay. SARFAESI Act provides the legal basis for these institutions that are set up that help in reconstruction of bad assets without intervention of the courts. So we have a major problem that is of growing NPAs. Various steps have been taken to deal with this problem, to address this problem. There are certain institutions which are set up under the SARFAESI Act that buy these bad loans from the banks and help in the recovery. What do we call such financial institutions? We call them Asset Reconstruction Companies, ARCs. Answer to this question is option A. Now coming to the fact that why I am discussing it, that's because RBI formulated a committee which was working on this Asset Reconstruction Companies functioning and it has recommended certain suggestions, it has come up with certain recommendations to improve their functioning. Asset Reconstruction Companies bahut important role play karti hain. बैड असेट्स की रिकवरी में बहुत मेजर रोल प्ले करती हैं इसलिए उन लेकिन वो रिकवरी रेट बहुत अच्छा नहीं था जिस वजह से उनकी परफॉर्मेंस इंप्रूव करने की ज़रूरत थी. ये कमेटी बनी और इस कमेटी ने कुछ सजेशंस दिए हैं कि परफॉर्मेंस कैसे इंप्रूव हो सकती है. सो असेट रिकंस्ट्रक्शन कंपनीज एज वी डिस्कस्ड बाय द एनपीएस फ्रॉम द बैंक्स एंड हेल्प इन क्लीनिंग अप देयर बैलेंस शीट. So they usually buy these assets from the banks, provide them 15% cash and issue the security receipts for remaining 85%. We have discussed this various times while discussing about the NARCL bad bank, right? So this helps banks to focus on their normal business activities. So banks can sell off their bad loans and then they can focus on their core business. Now talking about this committee report, so this report is there on the RBI website. The comments are invited till December 15. So, ab comments invite kiye jayenge aur uske basis pe RBI fir final decision lega. Then finally, RBI will decide based on the comments that which recommendations will be implemented. So, coming to the why part, that why RBI formed this committee which has given these recommendations, that's because ARC's performance has remained lackluster. इतनी अच्छी परफॉर्मेंस नहीं रही है ARCs की. लेंडर्स को रिकवर ओनली 14.29% ऑफ द अमाउंट ओड. सो इन ऑर्डर टू इम्प्रूव देयर परफॉर्मेंस आरबीआई फॉर्मुलेटेड दिस कमिटी व्हिच वाज एग्जामिनिंग द इश्यूज एसोसिएटेड विद ARCs. सो वो एग्जामिन कर रही थी कि क्या इश्यूज हैं, कैसे हमें उन्हें ओवरकम करना चाहिए और ARCs की परफॉर्मेंस बेटर करनी चाहिए. So it has come up with certain set of suggestions. These suggestions will help banks get rid of the stressed loans. And it will help ARCs in raising more resources, which will help in the better recovery. Now, coming to some of the recommendations, बहुत से recommendations दिए हैं इस committee ने, कुछ हम लोग discuss कर लेते हैं. Let's discuss few of those recommendations so that you can get an idea of how we can improve the performance of ARCs. One is, it has recommended to have an online platform to sell the stressed assets. See, if you have an online platform, it will make sure that there is more transparency, there is more uniformity in the process of selling these stress loans. Okay, so online platform hona chahiye in stress loans ke sale ke liye, ye suggest kiya hai is committee ne. Secondly, it has also suggested to expand the scope of SARFAESI Act. So what this committee says, it says that ARCs should acquire the financial assets not only from banks and financial institutions, but from other entities as well. Okay. And these ARCs should be allowed to acquire financial assets from all entities, alternative investment funds, from FPIs, from asset management companies, from NBFCs. So basically, SARFAESI Act ka scope aur badhane ka suggestion diya hai. Then next suggestion is to provide additional resources. So for that, ARCs should be allowed to sponsor SEBI-registered alternative investment funds. ऐसे funds ARCs को sponsor करना allow होना चाहिए because it will help ARCs raise more resources. ARCs के पास अगर ज़्यादा resources होंगे तो वो उनका use करके better restructuring कर सकता है bad loans की. Then is using IBC. Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code plays a very important role in dealing with these stressed loans. So in allowing the ARCs to resolve the stress assets in collaboration with IBC. Okay, the regulation should allow ARCs to use IBC for recovery part. Okay, then is large loans for sale to ARCs. There are some loans which are really very large, or there are loans which have been in default for over 2 years. They should be considered for sale to ARCs by banks. So large loans hote hain, unhe bank ko ARCs ko sell kar dena chahiye. So, उसके लिए जो final approval है वो एक proper high level committee से लेना होगा ताकि जो price discovery हो रही है किस price पे हमें sell करना है वो ज़्यादा true and fair हो. To make sure that there is true fair price discovery in the auctions of the sale of these stress assets, a final approval of the price should be taken by the high level committee. Coming to the next thing, that is debt aggregation. That means how much is the total principal or interest which is owed by a debtor to the creditors. अब एक borrower ने overall कितना loan ले रखा है सब lenders से. Okay, so इसके respect में इस committee ने क्या कहा है? This committee has said that if 66% of the lenders agree that they will accept the offer by ARC, then the same will be binding on remaining as well. So 66% lenders अगर decide करते हैं कि जो loans हैं वो अब ARCs को sell कर दिए जाएंगे, तो बाकी बचे हुए जो lenders हैं उन्हें भी उस चीज़ में agree करना पड़ेगा. And if they are not agreeing, then they have to maintain 100% provision on the loans outstanding. Then talking about NARCL, see, NARCL has also been formed, bad bank, to deal with the resolution process of these stress assets only. So what this committee has recommended? It has recommended that RBI needs to ensure a fair competition between the two. यानी कि NARCL और जो प्राइवेट ARCs है दोनों के बीच ही फेयर कंपटीशन होना चाहिए. इफ देयर इज फेयर कंपटीशन देन करेक्ट प्राइस डिस्कवरी विल बी देयर एट विच दीज लोन्स विल बी सोल्ड टू द प्राइवेट और द गवर्नमेंट ARC रन अंडर NARCL. सो दीज आर फ्यू रिकमेंडेशंस. देयर आर मेनी मोर रिकमेंडेशंस. लेट्स सी व्हाट पब्लिक कमेंट्स कम अप एंड व्हाट डिसीजन इज टेकन बाय द RBI एज फार एज दिस ARC's performance is concerned. So this was all for today's session. With this, I would like to end up this session. Thank you so much.